you ready? Are you ready? Get on your walking shoes. Somebody get ready. We're going to Washington. On this day, ladies and gentlemen, 50 years ago, as you've heard repeatedly on the Mall in Washington, D.C., Dr. Martin Luther King spoke of his dreams for this nation of ours. But the question today is, what can each of us do to advance that dream? And I believe it was a question posed in part by Dr. Emerson, Hosea Williams' daughter. When I think, ladies and gentlemen, of the suffering and the bloodshed and even the deaths of people who wanted to make certain that we had a right to vote and that we had a right for the noble creed of this country, the right to life, liberty, and pursuit of happiness. The sacrifice that I can make of my comforts, of contentment, and obscurity to share the experience and knowledge that I have gained over all these years for the least and the lost, I freely do. This day is significant. It could be a new beginning in our history here in the state of Georgia. And ladies and gentlemen, on this day, in the shadow of the Confederates, it is my privilege and my honor to formally announce that I am a candidate for the United States Senate for the great state of Georgia. And that I want to be that representative voice for this state, which has been my home, my beautiful home, for over 30 years. And ladies and gentlemen, we're going to Washington with a moral vision. We're going to Washington to try to help bridge the political, the racial, and the economic divide here in Georgia and in our nation. We're going to Washington to try to bring jobs to Georgia by forging new alliances. We're going there to bring real rail to Georgia so that we can move our people and products from point A to point B and get them to more destinations with ease. And to get, ladies and gentlemen, those federal dollars necessary to dredge the port of Savannah to allow bigger boats to come and go. We're going to Washington, ladies and gentlemen, to make certain that everyone has equal access and ease of voting and to restore provisions of the Voting Rights Act, which was eviscerated by the U.S. Supreme Court with one of our own Georgians sitting there casting the vote to deny people their full rights to vote. And I speak of Supreme Court Justice Clarence Thomas. We're going to Washington to fight, ladies and gentlemen, for clean, renewable energy like solar and wind, and against fossil fuels that help cause global warming and create extreme climate changes that are giving us unseasonable rains and flooding and heat waves and forest fires. And when we get there, ladies and gentlemen, we will fight to make certain that women receive equal pay for equal work. And we will fight to make certain that a woman's reproductive rights remain the sacred domain of women, their doctors, and their God. We will fight, ladies and gentlemen, for human dignity for each and every one of us here in Georgia and in this nation. We will fight against homophobia. I believe, please be very clear, that I believe in the sanctity of marriage between a man and a woman, but I have no right to dictate my beliefs and tell someone else who they should love and who they want to enter into a civil union with in their way of demonstrating that love. We will fight for equal quality for all of our children, fighting for a quality education that would allow me, without a journalism degree, to be able to win all kinds of Emmys and every other journalism award there is because of a quality education. Ladies and gentlemen, I want the same for all of our children. No more college educated children coming out not being able to put together a decent sentence or speak the King's English. I will fight for a quality education for our children. Teaching science and math and technology for the new jobs that are becoming available. Finding aptitudes of these children so that we teach to the hand as well as to the head. And we will work to abolish No Child Left Behind because it has left too many children behind. If you've noticed, this week is perhaps the most sunshine we've had for the entire month of August. And these extremes, ladies and gentlemen, are part of that global warming that I spoke of earlier. It threatens all of us, and we must invest in those renewable energies of wind and solar and water. Water is life, and we must stop polluting our rivers and streams. When we get to Washington, we will continue the fight for expanded background checks and a ban on those killing assault weapons in the hands of criminals and the mentally unstable. We are going to fight on the federal level against all ill-conceived laws that allow a George Zimmerman to snuff out the life of an unarmed teen and then be able to walk free. We will fight, ladies and gentlemen, for our veterans to make sure that never again should our brave men and women who have laid their lives on the line come home to have to worry about the basic necessities of life and proper treatment for their physical and psychological wounds. We will fight for them that fought for us. We will stop the delays, the denials, and the bureaucratic bungling that plagues our veterans when they are trying to receive their benefits. Ladies and gentlemen, we will fight for prison reform, that new slavery that Michelle Alexander talks about, so that full rights are restored to individuals who, yes, have erred, but have paid their debt to society. And we will relight the flame of that woman standing in the New York Harbor who says, bring me your huddled masses yearning to be free. No more separation of families and barriers and fences on the south end, but not the north end, to those individuals who would come to this country seeking gainful employment to take care of their families. We were all immigrants at one point in our life. We will fight for immigration reform. And we will fight the senior citizen for the rights of all seniors so that we can enjoy our lives in our golden years and not have to worry about our Social Security or have to worry about our Medicaid. We will fight for the seniors of Georgia and all over this nation. Ladies and gentlemen, I go to Washington not for the status quo. I go to Washington not to make a name for myself. I go to Washington not to be seduced by the power that happens so often when people get elected and forget who elected them and why. I go to Washington not for that 1%, but for the 99% of us who work hard every day and know we don't have a silver spoon. We had to earn a stainless steel spoon while some people still don't even have a plastic fork. I go to Washington to make a difference for each and every one of us. I do not disparage those individuals who have worked hard and earned their places as CEOs in this country, but it seems to me a shame when the head of a major department store can make $17 million a year in basic salary and doesn't want to pay his people the average $29,000 a year that they earn. Something is wrong with that picture. And we need people in Washington who represent the working and middle class, who are the backbone and the spine of this country. We go to Washington to do the work, and we ain't scared.
You go, Steen.
And so, while the dreamer was killed, and many of his hard-working lieutenants have gone on to glory, they couldn't kill the dream. Because God keeps raising up his army to do the will of the people. I believe, ladies and gentlemen, I believe that we can indeed live out that noble creed of our founding fathers, that we are all created equal, and we are endowed by the Creator with certain inalienable rights, and that is life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. That dream in which Dr. King saw on the red hills of Georgia, the sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners would sit down, he said, at the table of brotherhood. Well, Dr. King, it's a daughter of former slaves who will take that seat with your help at the Senate table, a daughter with roots in what Dr. King called that desert state of Mississippi. We stand today, ladies and gentlemen, at the foot of a mountain carved with the faces of the sons of the Confederacy. And on this date, August the 28th, in the year of our Lord, 2013, the 50th anniversary of the March on Washington, we declare and we decree that we will take that mountain as one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. That is our hope. That is our dream. That is the substance of our faith. And we will pray together. We will work together, we will struggle together, and we will stand up for our freedoms together. So from here, in Stone Mountain, we join together to move Georgia forward. Nobody promised us that the road would be easy, but on this day, look around this audience. We are black, we are white, we are young, we are old, we are Asian, we are Indian, we are Jews, we are Gentiles, we are Muslims, we are Catholics. We are the people of this great state of Georgia. And so we say with the faith of a grain of a mustard seed,
amen.
Mountain, get out of our way. Mountain, get out of our way. Mountain, get out of our way. I may not, ladies and gentlemen, have the money of the others. I may not have the name of the others, but the message that I need for you to take from Stone Mountain Village this day is that I have the experience, I have the time, I have the focus, I have the heart, most importantly, which is motivated not by today's definition of politics, but generated by that genuine thing called love. And if you, ladies and gentlemen, are willing to help, if you are willing to help, and if you are willing to fight to make Dr. King's dream a reality in our lifetime, we can win. We will win. We can win, and we will win, and we will move Georgia forward. We will help move this nation. Forward. We're not going to stop. And just like that train that rolled through here, this train is moving all the way to Washington. I want to know, are you ready? Are you ready? Get on your walking shoes.